Hey guys, Tiffany with another video, and as if the title alone didn't tell you, my bare face is obviously letting you know that this is about to be a get ready with me. I promise you guys that I will come back and try out some of these new goodies that I have been picking up. I've been finding a lot of great stuff in the drugstore if you guys have been keeping up with my hauls, and then I also did an Ulta haul, so I got some goodies from there as well. And what better way than to try them out together? So yeah, let's get started. So I already did my brows and moisturized off camera. The moisturizer that I use is this new L'Oreal Hydrogenious moisturizer. They have different ones. This one, because I'm obviously combination oily, is for oily skin. Guys, I've been using this for like the past couple of days, and I have to tell you, I absolutely love this. Now, someone did ask me in that haul video I did, my latest What's New at the Drugstore video. Haven't checked it out. Link right there. Don't worry. You know I got you. But someone asked me if this was comparable to the Neutrogena. I think that one's called the Hydrogel. And I have that one. I do really love that one as well. The only difference I can see is that this one dries down faster than that one does. This one dries down and gives you more of like a moisturized matte type of finish a lot quicker than the Neutrogena Hydrogel does. So I probably would say I like this one better. Just because, again, I can use this one more in like the daytime, where with the Neutrogena Hydrogel, I tend to use that one more at night. So for the eyes, I'm going to be trying out this new Tarte Man Eater palette. Of course, the packaging is really, really cute. Here are how the colors look on the inside. I felt like these were like really good, like everyday type of shades. Like you could definitely create a lot of wearable looks from this palette. So I'm taking this brown shade right here, which is called Saucy. And then I'm also taking my Sephora Pro Crease number 10 brush, and I'm just going to apply that shade in my crease, and this is going to serve as the transition color for this look. Now, I know I said that 2017 is going to be my year to step out the box. So I'm definitely going to try to bring like more colorful looks, maybe in like the spring and the summertime. I can't make y'all 100% guarantee because I don't want to lie. But I really am going to do my best to, I don't know, step outside the box a little more. Because a lot of times I feel like even when I try to step outside the box, I still gravitate more towards like colors that I'm comfortable with, as opposed to just like going for like a complete blue look, or just like adding pinks and reds and things like that. And plus, I'm gonna try and bring you guys more tutorials. I do feel like tutorials are the area where I struggle with the most, but it's like, how are you gonna get better if you don't perfect it? So I know you guys ask for like tutorials and things on different looks. So I really am going to do my best to just give y'all what y'all want. I mean, I say all the time, my channel won't work without you guys' input. So I have to do better. So the next shade in the palette I'm going to be using is this shade right here. This is called Hypnotic. Now this is more of a shimmer shade, and normally I don't like to use shimmer shades anywhere else but on the lid. But I wanted to just try something a little different for this look. So I'm going to go ahead and apply it more into the outer V portion of my eye. The brush that I'm using is my Dillium 776 brush. So I'm going to go back in with that Sephora brush. I didn't add any shadow onto it or any extra product or anything. I'm just going to use whatever is left on the brush and just sort of blend those colors together. So going back into the palette, I'm going to take this dark brown shade right here. It's called Midnight. And I'm going to be using another Dillium Tools brush. This is also a 776 brush. It just has a different type of handle to it. So I'm just going to go ahead and apply that into my outer V area over the last shade, which was what? Hypnotic. So I'm just going in more to define the outer V. Now the one thing I am doing is I'm taking my brush and I'm sort of just like flicking it out, so that it kind of also creates like somewhat of a wing. So you guys can see I'm starting to just basically form like somewhat of a wing in the outer corner as well. But I just, again, want to define the outer V. You guys know I have like hooded eyelids and small eyes, so I don't have much definition to my eyes. So I always have to create the drama myself because it's just not there. It's not one of the things I was blessed with. So now I'm going to take a clean blending brush. This is the Delium 785 brush, and I am just going to go in and blend everything together. I have to say, so far I am really liking these eyeshadows. I feel like they are applying really nice onto the eye. I definitely feel like the colors would build up really nicely if need be. I'm a fan of Tarte eyeshadows. But I feel like they can sometimes be a hit or miss. Like every Tarte eyeshadow palette that comes out, I can't sit here and say that I'm a fan of, because I just feel like, you know, sometimes they do a really great job and then sometimes I just be looking at them like, Tarte, what was y'all thinking? So the next shade that I'm going to use is right here. This shade is called Purr. It's not really like a nude shade. It has a little bit of like mauviness to it. I'm going to take this flat brush that I got from Peach and Pearl, and I'm just going to apply that shade on the lid. So it doesn't give like a whole lot of color, but it definitely gives just like a little bit of like fleshy tone color, and it has a little bit of shimmer to it. So just to make sure everything just kind of blends in together, I'm going to go back into that shade right there, which is called Hypnotic. I'm using the same brush, and I'm just going to sort of blend it into the Purr color and then blend it out into the outer V. And again, just to make sure that everything is just cohesive and it all blends out together. So now I'm going to take this Max Factor Masterpiece High Precision Liquid Eyeliner. I recently picked this up from Walgreens. It has like a flat tip to it. I don't know if you guys are going to be able to see it, but I'm going to use it to create a wing. And I really like this because I feel like it can just give you that preciseness that you need when creating a wing. And to me, it's super easy to use. I feel like the flat tip of it, it just allows you to kind of like effortlessly create a wing. And you can make it as thin or as thick as you would like it to be. So I went ahead and applied the lashes off camera. You guys already know, if you're familiar with my channel, that I struggle with applying my lashes, especially on camera. But I do think that if you are someone like me who can't just pop your lashes on with a tweezer, the lashes that I'm wearing are super beginner friendly. These are the Eylure number 126 lashes. These are their definition lashes. I got these from Ulta. They were $4.99. The one thing I love about the Eylure lashes, again, the band is like super lightweight. It does not take a lot of effort to apply them. And I love the fact that they come with a lash glue and also an applicator. So for primer, I'm going to be trying out this new Urban Decay D-Slick primer. Urban Decay came out with like four new primers or something like this. This one is the complexion primer. It's for shine control, pore minimizing, and for mattifying. But here is how it looks. So it does have like a little bit of a color to it. So I'm just gonna apply it, and I can say initially you can kind of instantly feel that it is a matte primer. Like how you know some primers, it takes like a little while for you to actually like feel the primer doing anything as far as like matting out your face. This one, it's definitely more of like an instant primer. Now the one thing I don't really care for, it kind of like flakes up. I don't know if that's going to show on camera. and maybe I just have to apply less of the primer, but I definitely can see where like the primer is like flaking up, and I am not a fan of that. I definitely don't have to worry about that with the MAC Time Check lotion. But yeah, it's starting to just like flake up around the edge part of my face. Like eraser shavings. That's what I mean when I say like flake up. It's like flaking. Oh no, that's definitely not cute. So for concealer, I'm just gonna apply my Kat Von D concealer cream underneath the eye. This one is in the shade D35 Neutral. And as you can see, this one is basically just like a skin tone concealer. And I'm just gonna use my Real Techniques brush. This is the Real Techniques setting brush. And I'm just going to blend that out underneath the eye. So for foundation, I'm not using a new foundation. I'm gonna just use one that I have not used in a while. This is the Urban Decay Naked Skin Weightless Ultra Definition Foundation. I have mine in the shade 9.0, so I'm just gonna go ahead and shake that up. But what I am gonna use to apply it is the new L'Oreal sponge. I have not used this yet. I've already wet it, so that's why it's looking a little big. But I've heard really great things about this. I'm not sure how it's gonna apply with this foundation, but this is the foundation I'm going with, so we're definitely gonna see. So I gotta say, I'm really impressed with this so far. I do feel like it applied the foundation evenly. I'm not seeing like any streaks or anything like that. I really do like how this feels, although it does have like a different shape. It has more of like a contour type of shape to it. I feel like feeling wise, like the way it feels when it's damp, if that makes any sense, definitely puts me in the mind of the Beauty Blender. And that was my issue with a lot of like Beauty Blender dupes, especially the ones that are shaped like this. I felt like even when you wet them, they still had like a hardness to them. They weren't as like buoyant as I want them to be. But this one to me definitely is probably the most comparable, just like the way it feels and the way it applies foundation to me, Beauty Blender wise, so far. So now I'm gonna go ahead and just add some bronzer and just bring back some warmth to my face. The bronzer that I'm gonna be using is the Pixel Triple Boost Matte Powder. I don't know if you guys remember when Ulta used to sell Pixel products, because I remember when I was in Florida and I picked up a couple of like Pixel lip glosses and I got them from Ulta, but I actually got this from Kmart. Here is what it looks like on the inside. This is the shade 08. Now I don't know if they were just doing like a sale on Pixel products or whatever, but I picked this up for $2.99 and I don't believe that was what the original price was. I try to see if I can find any links to it and I'll list them down below in the description box if I can. But either way, again, this is the shade 08 and I just thought this would make for a really nice like bronze and powder. So for blush, I'm gonna use the new Too Faced Papa Don't Peach blush. Now, originally I figured I would use this as a highlighter, and of course I'm still gonna use it as a highlighter, but I also wanna kinda see how this product would work as like a blush topper or just as a blush itself. So that is how it looks on the inside. I'm one of those people, I really love like peachy blushes, but this one just has more shimmer to it and more highlight, so. I think that's really pretty. It has such a gorgeous sheen to it. I played around with this in Ulta. I honestly had like no intention whatsoever of picking this up, but when I swatched it, I was just like, oh my goodness, I need that in my life. And again, if you are of a deeper skin tone, I think as a not as a blush, but as a highlight, this would be absolutely stunning. And then now for highlighter, I'm going to be using the new Milani Golden Light Spotlight Highlighter. Here is how it looks on the inside. I have talked about this before to you guys. I am so impressed with these new highlighters that Milani has come out with. It does have like 3 different colors in it. I don't know if you guys can see. I think in my last Get Ready With Me, I used number 01. This is number 03 Golden Light. But to me, they're all just equally gorgeous. And what I like to do is just put my brush and just kind of like mix all the colors. And then this particular one just gives like the prettiest, I don't know, like bronzy, golden type of glow to the face. And again, when you like mix all the colors, because it has like that dusty rose type of color in the middle, I don't know, it's just like hello bronze goddess. So before I apply my lipstick, I'm just gonna take this new Milani setting spray. This is the Milani Make It Last setting spray. It says it's supposed to prime, correct, and set, and it's supposed to be for 16-hour wear. I'm just gonna shake it up. I don't know why, I just have a habit of shaking everything up. Let me know if I'm not the only one who does that, but I'm gonna shake it, get this hair out my face, and ooh, it has a really nice smell to it. And y'all know I'm normally like sensitive to smells. It has like a really nice, I don't know, like fragrant type of smell. And I love that it has a direct spray. So you spray it and it's not like getting all over the place. Like it's like a direct type of mist. And I really, really like that so far. Oh, it just has such a clean type of smell. I don't know. But I like it. So for the lips, I'm going to be using 2 of the new NYX lingerie lip colors. You guys know they've added a whole bunch of new colors to the NYX lingerie line. I know for sure they are already in Ulta as far as when they're going to be popping up anywhere else like CVS or anything like that. I don't know, because I feel like it took forever for the original ones to pop up in drugstores. So you probably just want to keep your eye out. But you know, with the NYX products in Ulta, you can use that like $3.50 off coupon where you normally can't use them on prestige products. But the first one I'm going to start with is After Hours, and this one is just more of a brownie type of color that I thought would be really pretty. I'm going to take this next color, which is called French Maid, and this one just has more of a mauve-y type of tone to it, and I'm going to apply that one on top.